Good morning and welcome to St. Lawrence Church. It's beautiful to be back in church at Christmas. This is our midweek service and today we're going to have a slight difference. I'm going to do a small calm before the storm. For those of you who are regular to St. Lawrence's, we usually do a calm before the storm for the first week of Advent. So first of all, let's light the candles. So we come and we light, hopefully, the first candle of Advent. And as we light this, let's sing together, O come, Emmanuel.
Thank you.
darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing it and upholding it with justice and righteousness. From that time on and forever, the zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. And while they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. blue homespun and the bend of my breast. Keep warm this small, hot, naked star fallen to my arms. Rest, you who've had so far to come. Now nearness satisfies the body of God sweetly. Quiet he lays, whose vigour hurled a universe. He sleeps, whose eyelids have not closed before. His breath, so slight it seems no breath at all, once ruffled the dark deeps to sprout a world. Charmed by doves' voices, the whisper of straw, he dreams. Hearing no music from his other spheres. Breath, mouth, eyes, ears. He is curtailed, who overflowed all skies, all years, older than eternity. Now he is new. Now native to earth as I am, nailed to my poor planet, caught that I might be free, blind in my womb to know my darkness, ended, brought to this birth for me to be newborn, and for him to see me mended, I must first see him torn. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
There is one word that describes the night he came. Ordinary. The sky was ordinary. An occasional gust stirred the leaves and chilled the air. The stars were diamonds sparkling on black velvet. Fleets of clouds floated in front of the moon. It was a beautiful night. A night worth peeking out of your bedroom window to admire. But not really an unusual one. No reason to expect a surprise. Nothing to keep a person awake. An ordinary night with an ordinary sky. The sheep were ordinary. Some were fat. Some were scrawny. Some with barrel bellies and some with twigs like legs. Common animals. No fleece made of gold. No history makers. No blue ribbon winners. They were simply sheep. Lumpy, sleeping silhouettes on a hillside. And the shepherds? Peasants they were. Probably wearing all the clothes they owned. Smelling like sheep and looking just as woolly. They were willing to spend the night with their flocks. But you won't find their staffs in a museum, nor their writings in a library, because no one asked their opinion on social justice or the application of the Torah. They were nameless and simple. An ordinary night with ordinary sheep and ordinary shepherds. And were it not for a God who loves to hook an extra on the front of ordinary, the night would have gone unnoticed. The sheep would have been forgotten, and the shepherds would have slept the night away. But God dances amidst the common. And that night he did a waltz. The black sky exploded with brightness. Trees that had been shadowed jumped into clarity. Sheep that had been silent became a curious chorus. 1 minute the shepherd was dead asleep, and the next he was rubbing his eyes and staring into the face of an alien. The night was ordinary no more.
But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause you great joy and for all the people. Today in the town of David, a saviour has been born for you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart.
Frosty breath and feel the crunch of gravel as you walk the path towards the inn. Stop at its door and listen to the laughter inside. Now step around the corner to the back of the inn and pause before the stable. Smell the fragrance of hay and straw. Let the warm glow of the stable lantern touch your face. Hear the cry of a tiny infant. Now wait and listen. Hear the distant strains of singing angels. Step inside the stable and marvel at what you see. Draw near. Come close. Don't be afraid. This is the Lord of the universe. Come down to be with you. In your heart, kneel before your Lord. Come worship and adore him.
Love incarnate, love divine, star and angels gave the bow to babe on bended knee, the savior of humanity. Unto us a child is born.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem, in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go, search carefully for the child, and as soon as you find him, report to me so that I may too go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary. They bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. Let's sing together, "O come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant."
Joyful.
Let us pray. This Christmas time, the end of 2020, we ask, Father, that you kindle in us a love for you, which responds to you, which yearns for your return. We ask for peace and comfort for all those who have lost during this year. We've lost family, relationships. We've lost jobs. Father, we ask for your peace at this time. Father, cause our hearts to leap for joy as we anticipate the great fact of the future, your re-entry to earth. Pour into us a certainty that believes that all life is to be lived under the shadow of that miraculous return, the courage to live life your way, the resilience to hold on to that hope when times are hard. Bring us to Christmas Day, not irritated with the commercialisation with which it's surrounded, but rather rejoicing in the message of the angels. The first Christmas, that very, very first Christmas, on that day was born our Saviour. Hallelujah. I'm just going to dance the voice of hope. This is a song which was written just after 9/11 from Point Zero. And it's a voice of hope. Jesus is our voice of hope. Let's hang on to that until a vaccine has been found, until we are rid of this virus which has overtaken us since last year.
As high as the heavens are above.
And so we come again to Christmas. I hope and pray that you've found this time a special place to steal away to consider the true meaning of Christmas, to wonder in you at the lives which were so miraculously changed on that night long ago, but more importantly, how that night affects each and every one of us.